My grandmother used to laugh because one time she said to the Russian ambassador, perhaps someday you will have a parliament in Russia. And he said, God forbid, my dear Lady Russell. Except for the first word, the Russian ambassador at the present day might give the same answer. It was thought that there was going to be ordered progress throughout the world. Gradually, every country was going to take to parliaments. There was going to be a bicameral legislature and two parties, and it was all going to be exactly like England everywhere, all over the world. It was all going to be orderly, all quite nice. The atmosphere, apart from politics, it was one of Puritan piety, very great piety, very great austerity. The world where I was young was a solid world, a world where all kinds of things that have now disappeared were thought to be going to last forever. It didn't dawn on people that they would cease. English people certainly regarded English naval supremacy as a sort of law of nature. Britannia ruled the waves. It didn't occur to us that that might stop. Bismarck was regarded as a rascal and was thought of as a sort of uneducated farmer. But it was assumed that the influence of Goethe and Schiller would gradually bring Germany back to a more civilized point of view. Bismarck himself compared Germany and England to an elephant and a whale, each formidable in its own element, but no danger to each other. Yes, I can tell you something about my grandfather. He was born in the early years of the French Revolution. He thought English hostility to Napoleon was excessive, and he visited Napoleon in Elba.